Hello, my dear students. Today, once again, I am here in front of you with a new chapter. Name of the chapter is A Visit to Kaziranga and Sivasagar. So, before starting the chapter, I want to inform you one thing that because of this ongoing pandemic, the government of Assam has reduced some of the chapters from the syllabus. So, the chapters which were there in our second evaluation syllabus, some of them have been deducted. Only this chapter left in our second evaluation syllabus. Another chapter was there, The Bond of Love. This has been deducted. And another poem was also there, No Man Are Foreign. That one also has been deducted. So only this chapter left. And in repetitor also, one chapter we had in our second evaluation syllabus, that chapter has been deducted. So in first paper, we have only this chapter left for our second evaluation syllabus. Let's start it. Before you read, it is there in your book, you can see. That means before going into the chapter, we should read these things. So in before you read, what we get? We get the what about the chapter. We get the what about the chapter means the chapter is all about which thing. We'll get the information about that. Let's see what is there in before you read. Do you enjoy traveling? First, we are asked a question that do we like to travel? The writer Shrutimala Dwara, who has traveled extensively, narrates here how two children traveled with their parents to a national park and also to a place of historical interest. Here in this chapter, the writer Shrutimala Dwara, who had traveled extensively, that means in many places, she traveled. And here in this chapter, she is going to discuss about two children who traveled with their parents, where? To a national park and also to a place of historical importance in Assam. Next, do you know that there are several national parks in Assam? Another question is asked. That means whether we know the several national parks are there in Assam. Yes, we know so many national parks are there in Assam. We got it in our SST class. It is there in class 6, 7, 8, 9 up to class 9 also. We got about the national parks of Assam. Not only one, more than one national parks are there in Assam. Kaziranga National Park, which spreads over the civil jurisdiction of Nagaon and Golaghat districts, reaching the hills of Karbi Anglong district, is one of them. So out of other national parks, one is what? Kaziranga National Parks, and it spreads where? It is it covers the jurisdiction of Nagaon district and Golaghat district. That means some part of Nagaon and some part of Golaghat districts are covered by Kaziranga National Parks, and even it reached up to the hills of Karbi Anglong district. It is famous for one horned rhinos. Kaziranga National Park is famous for one horned rhinos. So we know that Assam is famous for one horned rhinos, and in Assam, no, this Kaziranga National Park is famous for one horned rhinos. That means one horned rhinos live there. Can you name some other national parks of Assam? It is up to you. Do you know the names of some other national parks of Assam? Yes, I hope you know. While discussing, no, we may discuss about those national parks. Have you heard of the historical town of Sivasagar? The next question is asked. What is the question? Whether we know about the historical town of Sivasagar. We know that there is a town in Assam. Name of the town is what? Sivasagar. And it is a historical town. And we are asked whether we know anything about this historical town, Sivasagar. Most of we know about that. What is there in Sivasagar? We will discuss in detail in the chapter. So, why it is historically important? See, The Ahoms established their rule over Assam with the capital at Sivasagar during the early part of 13th century. During the early part of 13th century, when Ahom kings were ruling in Assam, they established their kingdom at Sivasagar. Early part of 13th century, when Ahoms were ruling over Assam, they established their kingdom at Sivasagar. It is a place worth visiting. And it is said that Sivasagar is a place worth visiting. That means it is, if someone visits Sivasagar, then he will enjoy it much. That means his money, the money what he will spend for visiting Sivasagar will not go in vain. That means it is not wasted. If someone goes there, he can enjoy it very nicely. Okay, he will have a lot of things to enjoy. He will get a lot of things to cherish about. Can you find some other, some more such historical places in Assam? Then the question is asked once more, that can we say the names of some other places, those are historically important in Assam? Yes, while discussing, we'll discuss about some other places of Assam, those are historically important. Now, let's start the chapter. Lohit and Trisha got up early in the morning before their mother could wake them up. Lohit and Trisha said no at the beginning. The writer Shrutimala Dwara, she will discuss about the traveling of two children with their parents. So these two children are Lohit and Trisha. Today, the day of their visiting, the day of their traveling, they got up early in the morning. Normally or generally what happens, their mother wakes them up in the morning, but today they have to travel, no? That's why before their mother came to them to wake them up, they both of them woke up. Usually they love to sleep till late in the morning when they had no school. Usually what happens, generally what happens when they do not have school, that means when vacations are going on, what they do, they sleep late in the morning. Okay, so it happens to us also. Sunday we don't have a school, so what we do, we sleep late in the morning. That means today we don't have any work. If up to 8, if up to 7, or if even up to 9, if we sleep, there will be no problem. So it happens to everyone, not only Trisha and Lohit, it happens to everyone. So the time when they were ready to go for traveling, it was the time of vacation. So they do not have, they did not have their school also. That's why on that particular morning, they wake them up quick, they woke up quickly. But generally or usually what happens when they do not have school, they sleep till late in the morning. But that morning, they were too excited to sleep. But that morning, both of them were too excited to sleep. That means they were so interested in sleeping. But then also, though they were being forced by their drowsiness, that they had to sleep. But that morning, they woke up. Their parents would be taking them to Sivasagar. Why? They were too excited to sleep because it was known to them that their parents were going to take them to Sivasagar, and they were not ready to go to Sivasagar because it was means what, Sivasagar was unknown to them. On their way, they would spend a night at Kaziranga. Plan was like that. That means while going to Sivasagar, what will happen? On their way, they will stay one night at Kaziranga. Okay, Kaziranga National Park. Every year in the past, during school holidays, their father took them to different places, sometimes outside Assam, sometimes within Assam. Everywhere what happens, during vacations, when schools are not there, what happens, their parents take them for traveling to various parts, sometimes within Assam and sometimes they go for outside Assam also. Assam is a unique land with tea gardens, ancient temples, national parks, historical monuments, and whatnot. Assam is a unique land. why Assam is a unique land. Unique land means what? It is one of the special lands. Why? Because it is full of tea gardens. We know that Assam is famous for its tea gardens. Not only for tea gardens, Assam is famous for some other things also. Here it is said that Assam is a unique land of what? Tea gardens. And it is a unique land of ancient temples like what? Temple is there in Guwahati. Do you know the name of the temple? What is the name of the temple? Can anybody say? You remember. Because Assam is famous for this particular temple. You remember. If you cannot, then in my discussion, I'll tell you. National parks. So many national parks are there. One of them is what? Kaziranga National Parks. So Assam is not only famous for tea gardens, I said. Assam is famous for what? Tea gardens, then ancient temples, then national parks, then historical monuments. So many historical monuments are also there. Even in Badarpur, no, we have a historical monument in Badarpur Ghat. There is a fort, old fort. This is a historical monument. So in Silchar, in Kachar district, we know about Khashpur. This is also a historical monument. And what not? And then it is said, what not? That means, what is not there in Assam? All those things make Assam a unique land. Who said this? Their father said to them. To whom? To Trisha and Lohit. You should know your own state. Father is saying that you should know your own state. Yes, we are living in Assam. We must know about our own state. Okay? But we people know, we know about Delhi, we know about Agra, what is there in Delhi, what is there in Agra, what is there in Mumbai, all those things are known to us, but most of us do not know much about our own state. That's why, no, their fathers said to them that you must know about your own state. Last year, they had visited their uncle who lived in Tezpur. Okay, last year during vacation, they visited their uncle who lives in Tezpur. We know that Tezpur is a district of Assam. And now there is a medical college also in Tezpur. So last year they visited Tezpur. Who lives there? Uncle of Trisha and Lohit lives there. So they visited their uncle there. Both Lohit and Trisha enjoyed their stay there so much that they wanted to go again there. So last year while staying at their uncle's place, they enjoyed it very much. They enjoyed it too much. Okay? And because of that, no, this year also, they want to go to Tezpur. Okay? Last year, they went there. They visited Tezpur. Their uncle lives there. Because of that, because of their enjoyment, they enjoyed a lot last year. Because of their enjoyment, this year also, they want to go to Tezpur. But their father said, this time I'll take you to Sivasagar. But their father said, no, we are not going to Tezpur. This time I'm taking you to Sivasagar. Okay? And the place Sivasagar is not known to them. They know Tezpur because last year they visited Tezpur. That's why this year also they want to go to Tezpur. But their father said, no, we are not going to Tezpur this time. We are going to Sivasagar this time. What they are to see in Sivasagar, let's go to uncle's house in Tezpur instead. Lohit pleaded. Lohit pleaded means Lohit requested. What is there in Sivasagar to see? Let's go to Tezpur instead. Okay, Tezpur, we have our uncle and so many things are also there to enjoy. We enjoyed it last year too much. And what is there in Sivasagar? Because it is not known to him. No, that's why he said, he requested his father that let's go to Tezpur once again. Instead of Sivasagar, let's go to Tezpur once again. Don't you want to see a new place? You had already seen Tezpur. We will go there again someday. Father said, don't you want to go to a new place? We visited Tezpur last year. No problem. This year, let's go to Sivasagar. Let's go to a new place. You enjoyed Tezpur. You came to know a lot about Tezpur last year. Let's go to a new place. Don't you want to know something new about a new place? And if we get time, no, some other day we'll go to Tezpur once again. Why is he saying like this? He is saying like this because Lohit was a small boy and he wants to go to Tezpur once again. That's why without breaking his heart, his father is saying that let's go to Sivasagar this time. It's a new place. We'll get to know a lot of things, a lot of new things in Sivasagar. Once again, if we get some time, no, we'll get to go to Tezpur. But this time, let's go to Sivasagar. Let me tell you about the place. Okay? You don't have any knowledge about Sivasagar. That's why I know you don't want to go to Sivasagar. Let me tell you something about Sivasagar. Then your interest will arise. And then you will be eager to go to Sivasagar. So, what he said about Sivasagar, it is written here. It was formerly known as Rangpur. Okay? The ancient name of Sivasagar was what? Rangpur. Who said? Father of Trisha and Lohit said the ancient name of Sivasagar was what? Rangpur. It was the capital of Ahom kingdom, Ahom kings from 1699 to 1788. This Rangpur, present Sivasagar, was the capital of Ahom kings. Okay, at the beginning of the chapter I said, when Ahoms were ruling over Assam, they established their kingdom in the early part of 13th century, where? In Sivasagar. So here he said, Sivasagar, that means ancient Rangpur, was the capital of Ahom kings from when? From 1699 to 1788. For this 88, that means for these 89 years, Rangpur, that means the present Sivasagar, was the capital of Ahom kings. You can see many tanks, many palaces and beautiful temples of that period of time. You will love to see them. Going there, you can see many tanks, that means tanks made by kings, ancient kings. Tanks made in those periods, 1699 to 1788, historical tanks. Many palaces. Palaces means what? Buildings made by kings, okay? Where kings used to live. Those palaces we can see there, historical palaces. It is not place, palace. Beautiful temples. Going there, we can see beautiful temples. Those were made during those periods, 1699 to 1788. And what he said, you will love to see them. When we'll go there, if you see, you will love to see all those things. Now you are saying, no, you don't want to go to Sivasagar, but all those things are there. Ancient tanks are there, ancient palaces are there, beautiful temples are there. And those are made in between 1699 to 1788. So ancient things, okay? And those are preserved by government. So if we go and if you see them, then you will enjoy it a lot. Because of this reason, no, I want to take you to Sivasagar. Then he continued, on our way, we can stay for a night at Kaziranga. Okay, while going to Sivasagar, what will happen? One night we'll stay at Kaziranga National Park. Their mother suggested. No, here her father stopped there. You will love to see them. Up to that, their father said. Now, their mother started. She said, on our way to Sivasagar, for one night, no, we'll stay where? We'll stay at Kaziranga National Park. Oh, lovely, Lohit said, clapping his hands. Now, he is excited to go to Sivasagar. When he heard about Kaziranga, he started clapping his hand. Yes, lovely thing. Yes, this time we'll go to Kaziranga also. We can take an elephant ride and see the rhino. He said, going there, what will happen? We can take a ride of elephant. Okay, in Kaziranga, if you go to visit Kaziranga, two ways are there. You can take a ride of elephants, or carts are also there, protected carts. Through that, you can visit or you can take a look of whole national park. So it was known to Lohit. He read about this in his books. So he was excited and said that, yes, going there, what will happen? We'll take a ride of an elephant and we'll see what? The rhino, the famous rhino. Which rhino? Famous rhino we find in Kaziranga, the one horn rhino for which Assam is famous. So Kaziranga National Park is in Assam is famous for what? One horn rhino. And Lohit was excited to see them. One more thing he was excited. What was that? He will take a ride of elephant, he said, to see the whole national park. That's why, you know, he was happy now. Earlier he was sad because he doesn't know anything about Sivasagar. His father said a lot about Sivasagar, and when their mother said that, while going to Sivasagar, we'll stay for a night at Kaziranga. Listening to that, Lohit was very much excited and he started clapping his hand and said, we'll take a ride of elephant. Why? To see what? The whole national park. And we'll see the one horned rhinos also. As the day of their visit dawned, Lohit and Trisha grew quite excited. The day of their visit dawned. Dawn means what? D-A-W-N. Dawn means what? Very early in the morning. Okay? So, the very early in the morning of their visit. What happened? Lohit and Trisha grew quite excited. Lohit and Trisha became too much excited. Yes, today we are going to start our journey. They would get to see both Kaziranga, the world-renowned national park, and Sivasagar, a famous historical town. Why they were excited? Because they will come to see what? The world-renowned national park, Kaziranga. It is world-renowned. Why? Because of one horned rhino. So they were, Trisha and Lohit, both brothers and sisters, they were what? Excited, because they are going to see Kaziranga. Kaziranga, what it is? It is world's renowned national park. And they will visit Sivasagar also, a famous historical town in Assam. So they are going to enjoy both the places. That's why both of them were very much excited. The morning arrived. Now the morning arrived in dawn also. Okay, at dawn also they were excited. Now after dawn, morning arrived, and they started their journey in their own car. Now they started their journey in their own car. Their father had a car, and in their own car they started their journey. By early afternoon they reached Kaziranga. By early afternoon, okay, that means just at the starting of afternoon, they reached what? Kaziranga National Park. Wake up, their mother called out. We have arrived. So in car, no, they were sleeping. Both of them were sleeping or drowsing. So when they reached Kaziranga, their mother woke them up, said, we arrived, woke up. Lohit and Trisha, who had fallen asleep on the back seat of the car, woke up. When their mother called them, both of them woke up. They were sleeping at the back seat of their car. So when they heard that we arrived, both of them woke up. They checked in at a hotel that had a large compound. So now they checked in. That means they had booked a room in a hotel that had a big compound. That means that had a big boundary. After freshening up, they sat on the cane chairs in one corner of the veranda and started to enjoy the greenery around. So after entering into the hotel, what they did? They freshened up. Okay, they took bath or they washed their face and hands, and they made themselves fresh. After making themselves fresh, they sat on what? Cane chair in the corner of the veranda of that particular hotel where they were staying. Okay. Cane chairs are famous in Kaziranga. Okay, not only in Kaziranga, in most of the hotels in Assam, Assam is famous for this tea gardens, and Assam is famous for the furnitures made of what? Canes. So they got cane chairs and they sat on the cane chairs. Where it was kept? It was kept in the corner of the veranda of that particular hotel. Cane chairs means the chairs made up of bamboos or some other plants. What they were doing sitting on the veranda? They were enjoying the greenery around. They were inside the boundary of Kaziranga National Park. So all around the hotel, it was green, green and green everywhere. So they were enjoying the greenery all around. Now, what happened, you see? Can we go to see the rhino now? Lohit asked. Now Lohit asked his parents, can we go to see the rhino now? So we have freshened up. Can we go to see the rhino now? He's asking his parents. No, not today. We'll go tomorrow, early in the morning, his father said. His father said, no, today we are not going. We're going to take rest for tonight. Okay? Tomorrow early in the morning, we'll go to see rhino, not only rhino, the will visit the whole national park. Who said this? His father. Rohit asked, today, that means we have freshened up, now can we go to see the rhino? His father said, no, today we are not going, we will go to visit the national park tomorrow morning. On elephant back, asked Rohit, his eyes shining with excitement. Now, with opening his eyes in amusement, in excitement, he was asking his father, on elephant's back or not? That means, will we visit or will we see the whole national park sitting on elephant's back or not? He's asking. Yes, his father smiled. His father, in smiling face, his father said, yes, yes, my son, we are going to see or we are going to visit the whole national park sitting on elephant's back. Kaziranga is called a national park. What is a national park? Rohit asked. Now you see. Question, what was there in our mind? That one came. Rohit asked his father, father, Kaziranga is a national park, isn't it? So what is a national park? It is not known to me. Can you please tell me what is a national park? We know that. That means Rohit is asking, I know that. Everyone knows that Kaziranga is a national park. We read about that in our books. Now he is asking his father, what is a national park? Why Kaziranga is called a national park? It is a park that is used for conservation purpose. Now his father is replying that it is a park used for what? Conservation purpose. Okay. His father said Kaziranga is a national park because it is used for conservation purpose. What is being conserved there? Plants and animals. Conserve, understand, protect. Okay. So it is used for protecting what? Animals and plants. That's why it is a national park. We have the rare one-horned rhinos that we need to conserve. We have no, we Assam. That means we the people of Assam have one very rare thing. What is that? One-horned rhino. Okay? And it needs to be conserved. It needs to be conserved. And Kaziranga National Park is used for conserving this one-horned rhino. Not only one-horned rhino is conserved here, so many other flora and fauna are also being conserved here. So national parks, from here we have understood, national parks are used for conservation purpose. What is to conserve? Animals, that is flora and fauna, will be conserved, flora and fauna to be conserved in national parks. And here in Kaziranga, what we conserve? We conserve the rare one-horned rhino. It is rarely found in Assam, and in Assam it is found in Kaziranga. So we must conserve it. So we are conserving it where? In Kaziranga National Park. Are there only rhinos in this big park? Asks Rohit. Now next question. Rohit is a small boy. So small boys and girls, they are eager to know a lot. Okay. So when he heard that Kaziranga National Park, this one-horned rhino, rare one-horned rhino is conserved. Now he is asking the next question, are there only rhinos in this big park? He is asking whether only rhinos are there in this big park. It is not a small park, no, from hotel he can see. It is a big national park. Now he is asking whether rhinos are only conserved here in Kaziranga National Park. Of course not, you silly boy, laughed his sister. His sister Trisha laughed and said, of course not, you silly boy, you are fool boy. So big national park it is. Do you think only rhinos will be conserved here, rhinos will be preserved here? You are silly boy, you don't know. She laughed and said, she made fun of Rohit. He was asking no silly questions. It's a big park, so many things will be there. But he was asking that whether only rhinos are kept here. Then her sister Trisha started laughing and said, you are silly boy. Of course not. Not only rhinos, some other things are also there in Kaziranga National Park. There are elephants and birds too. There in Kaziranga National Park, we will get elephants and rare kinds of birds are also there in Kaziranga National Park. We can see elephants and rare birds also. In fact, it is a park gifted with a wide variety of flora and fauna and is a home to animals like wild water buffaloes, Indian wild boar, sambar, barking deer, hog deer, leopard, Indian gray mongoose, white-browed gibbon, said their mother. Their mother said, yes, except no one-horned rhinos, elephants, and rare kinds of birds. So many other things are also there. In fact, factually what happens, her mother is saying, it is a park, means Kaziranga National Park is a park gifted with a wide variety of flora and fauna. It is gifted with what? That means here we will get as gift, what we will get? A wide variety of flora and fauna. Flora and fauna means what? Plants and animals. That means a wide range of plants. That means rare kinds of plants also will get here, and rare kinds of animals also will get here in Kaziranga. Not only rhinos, elephants and birds, a wide range of flora and fauna, that means a wide range of plants and animals are there, and we'll be able to enjoy, we'll be able to see all of them. And it is a home to animals like what? Wild water buffaloes. We have heard no buffaloes, we know them. That means we have seen them. They are land animals, but wild water buffaloes are also there, and it is available in Kaziranga. Indian wild boar, that means Indian wild boar also is available there in Kaziranga. Sambar is also available in Kaziranga. Barking deer we know. So naturally or generally we know that deers do not bark, but in Kaziranga we'll get barking deer also. We'll get hog deer. Hog deer, that means the deer, those do not make sound, they do not bark. So hog deer also will get there. Leopard, that means leopard is is one kind of tiger. That means it's a family member of tiger family, cheetah family. So leopard also will get to see there. And Indian gray mongoose, one kind of what? Monkeys will get to see them here in Kaziranga. White-browed gibbon also. Gibbon also will be able to see there in Kaziranga. Not only what? One-horned rhino, elephants and birds will get a wide variety of animals and plants there in Kaziranga. So whatever her mother said, except them also some other animals are available there in Kaziranga. Even we can see what? Deer, we can see bear also, we can see tigers also, we can see tortoise also. So many other things are also there. That means a wide variety of flora and fauna, a wide variety of plants and animals are available there in Kaziranga. When his father said it is famous for what? One-horned rhino. So he was thinking that only one-horned rhino is available there in Kaziranga. But her sister said no. In Kaziranga, except one-horned rhino, we can see what? Elephants and rare kinds of birds also. But her mother included some other thing, and I am including some more thing. That means except the things mentioned by Lohit, his sister and their mother, some other things are also available there in Kaziranga. And monkeys, Lohit quickly put in. Then Lohit said, you said about so many things and monkeys are there or not? He started asking once more whether monkeys are also available in Kaziranga or not. Yes, you will be one more of them, said his sister laughing. Yes, why not? Her sister said, yes, why not? We'll get a lot of monkeys there in Kaziranga, and I hope that to me, you are one of those monkeys. That means in smiling mood, she is calling her brother as a monkey. She said, yes, why not? Out of a lot of monkeys, you are one of them. Why to see monkeys? You are a monkey, no need to see other monkeys. But from her sentence, she said, a wide range of monkeys are also available. And she, trickled her brother, saying that he is one of all the monkeys. There are lots of capped langurs, also called leaf monkeys. Then she said, there are a lot of what? Capped langurs. Okay? Capped langurs means what? Capped monkeys. Okay? Their head is in such a way, it is shaped in such a way that it shows that a cap is there on their head. So she said, capped langurs are also there, and they are known as what? leaf monkeys. Okay, here in Kaziranga we'll get to see leaf monkeys. What is leaf monkey? What are leaf monkeys? Leaf monkeys are those langurs having cap-like shape on their head. She said that we'll get to see those langurs also in Kaziranga. Are there any snakes? Trisha asked. Trisha said, are there any snakes in Kaziranga? Now, Trisha is excited to know whether snakes are also available in Kaziranga or not. Yes, said their mother. Her mother said, yes, yes, snakes are also available. And tortoise? Then Trisha's question is, and tortoise? Whether tortoise is available or not in Kaziranga? So, tomorrow they are going to visit Kaziranga, but today they are getting an overall information about Kaziranga National Park from their parents. So they are asking questions one by one, and their parents are also replying the questions one by one. So when Trisha asked her mother that whether snakes are also available in Kaziranga or not, their mother said, yes, snakes are also available. We will be able to see snakes also in Kaziranga. Then her next question was what? Whether tortoise is available in Kaziranga or not. So what will happen after that, we'll get to know in our next class. So it's a long chapter. We'll divide it in various classes. Up to this today, up to this, what we got? Trisha and Lohit, they at first did not want to go to Sivasagar because last year they went to their uncle's house and they enjoyed a lot there. This year also they want to go to Tezpur, but their father said a lot of things about Sivasagar. And when he said that, on our way, when their mother said, on our way, we'll stay for a night at Kaziranga, both of them were excited. Okay. And then the next morning, they started to go to Sivasagar, and in between their journey, they will stay for a night at Kaziranga. They reached Kaziranga, they stayed in a hotel, and sitting in the hotel, they are getting an overall information about the Kaziranga National Park from their parents. So we read up to this today. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have any doubt regarding any word, or if you have not understood anything, if you have any queries, if you have any questions from here, you can contact me at night from 8 to 10 p.m. I'll be there to answer your questions, answer your queries. Till then, thank you. Thank you once again.